if there is a phase of attacking police posts, it wouldn't be wise to panic that it is a rebellion. Because we know, we understand the factors that are contributing to this, and it is better we deal with them.
Brigadier General Felix Kulaije was in Chikuwe District with the Minister of Defense and Veteran Affairs, Vincent Bamlangaji Sempije, together with two state ministers, Jacob Obothoboth and Huda Oleru, to conduct a state inspection of over 6 square miles of maize planted by the Chieftaincy of Production and Welfare in Changwali sub-county.
The government interventions since 1993, Rural Farmers Scheme, Bonabagagawale, Intandikwa, then came the Women Funds, the Youth Livelihood Program, then NADS, OWC. What happened to those interventions? Those who followed them and benefited from them according to instructions, their conditions of living changed. Okay? However, because of lack of leadership and mentorship in lower levels, young people went for quick money, sold land, bought border borders. Okay? Where did the philosophy of Nkumbi Teriyimba go?
During the visit, the army spokesperson, Brigadier General Felix Kulaije, noted that the spat of attacking security officers manning different security points in central Uganda is being done by criminals who are being misled by political actors.
Lack of interest in work by the younger people in the central region. Listening to rumor mongers instead of exchanging ideas with those who are supposed to inform them. For me, that's where the snag starts from. And of course, the political actors who keep on assuring them that the government is about to fall. And it's not about. This government is still in charge. So they have misled the young people to think, just pick a gun here, pick a gun there. Like you can easily rob a shop, you can easily overthrow the government. No. My appeal, that we are not poor. We have the resources, it's the mind that is still poor. Imagining a solution will come from elsewhere. But I want to tell you, young men, where you are, there are solutions to your problems.
Kulaije says 75% of the security threats are non-military, and they are now looking forward to supporting the increasing population.
The danger coming is a lack of land because of land fragmentation. You have 2 children or 3, you want to divide them with your 3 acres. So what will they grow when they have divided the 3 acres? Therefore, my argument is the very poverty you are talking about, first, is in our minds. 2, on our tongues, we who are supposed to teach people to change their lives. Has anybody asked the leaders we elect, councillors, MPs, what have they changed in the population? Why? Instead, 5,000 shillings, 2,000 for a vote.
The Uganda People's Defense Forces embarked on a campaign to end food insecurity in the country. The force and the Chieftaincy of Production and Welfare planted over 6 square miles of maize at the army farm in Changwali sub-county, Chikuwe district, with an aim of curbing the near-expected food shortage in the future. Compelled by Ambrose Niwagaba Katoto for the news.